Today, I'll be showing you how to add 3D text as well as showcasing a brand new feature in Blender 4.1. First of all, I'm going to press Shift A and then I'm going to left click text. This will add a brand new object to our scene, and if I press Tab to go into edit mode, rather than editing vertices, here we can actually edit the text. For example, I can press the backspace and just type like normal. In the right hand side of my Blender workspace, you can see there is a green A symbol, and this allows us to edit some of our text settings. For example, here we have the resolution preview, which if I turn this down, you can see this makes a very low poly text, and if I put this back to 12, you can see it's much more smooth. You can also left click and drag to highlight text like this, and you can use some of these examples here. For example, you can left click this underline option and now you can see the text is underlined. You can also adjust the size here as well, and to make the text more italic, you can use this shear slider here. Also, when you have the underline on, you can adjust the underline position using this slider here, and there's also an underline thickness slider too. But what was that new feature I was talking about? This is the ability to add emojis to our text objects in Blender. To do this, we will need to use a special website, which I'll have the link to in the description. Once you open the link, you'll come to this website here, and you can see we've got a bunch of emojis, as well as some code here. This is called the Unicode, and it's really important for adding emojis to Blender. So once you've found an emoji you like, I'm just going to choose this one here. We're going to left click and drag in order to highlight this text, and left click copy. Make sure to exclude the U+1, as we don't need it for Blender. Once you have those copied, you can come back to Blender, make sure you're in edit mode, and I can maybe just press the space bar, and I'm going to right click, and then under text, you can see we've got a new menu here. First, I'm going to left click insert Unicode, and then I can press Control V, and you can see that has now pasted my Unicode here. I can press insert, and now you can see we have our laughing face inside a Blender. You also notice if I right click and come to text, we have a special characters section, and here you can choose some other characters that you might want to add, for example a copyright symbol. But how can we go ahead and turn this into 3D text? Well, to do that, we need to change it from a text object to a mesh, which can be edited with vertices. So to do that, I'll come back into object mode by just pressing tab, or you can change it up here. Then I'll left click object, then under convert, I'm going to choose mesh. And now if I press tab to go into edit mode, you can see we can no longer edit the text, but instead we've now got all these as vertices. If you want to have a backup of your text, I would recommend duplicating this object when it's still a text object using Shift D so you can save it for later. For us though, I'm going to press tab to go back into edit mode, press A to select everything, and if I want to make this 3D, I can just press E, and I can maybe pull this up like this. And now you can see we've got ourselves some 3D text. One last thing I'll do is you can notice here that we don't have smooth shading here, and to fix that we could just right click, and in Blender 4.1 we could just choose Shade Smooth by Angle. If you're in an older version, you can just choose Shade Auto Smooth, and you'll notice if I press tab to go into edit mode, like I covered in my last Blender 4.1 tutorial, it's going to add all these blue lines to show the sharpness, and if you don't want those, you can use the modifier instead. So if you want to learn more about the new Shade Smooth features in Blender 4.1, I recommend checking out this video here. Thank you so much for watching, and take care. Thank you.